Hello and welcome. We're at the track with the Sport of Kings. Coming up, Canada-bound jockey Ricky Walcott gets the big race win in Barbados. The impressive demolition man scores a victory in the first leg of the Triple Crown Series in Antigua and Barbuda. There's racing from Jamaica and Trinidad and Tobago. But first to Barbados, the Garcia Savannah Handicap, the main event on the weekend.
Eight runners face the starter in the US $8,000 event over 9 furlongs on the Garcia Savannah turf. The top contenders, number 3, Jake Sam at 9-2 odds, Ricky Walcott astride. Number 6, Nikita, won 2 legs of the Barbados Triple Crown in 2013, the 2-1 favorite with Antonio Whitehall aboard. Number 7, Janax Gold, 9-2 with Rashawn Latchman. And the 8-horse Vanity Affair at 3-1 under Rashid Hughes. Check out Ricky Walcott positioning Jake Sam for a winning run with just under 4 furlongs to go.
I don't know how much more he has in the tank. As a matter of fact, the field, the leaders have not a lot, because on the outside, Captain Sully picks it up, and now you can change the guard. Jake, Janax Gold goes right through and picks it up. Here comes on the outside in second position. That one is Jake Sam. One running tremendous race on the outside is the favorite, Nikita, coming to get into it. The others are beginning to go backwards out of the pack. Here comes little man Aaron Riller, run from down in the rear. 6 furlongs in 115 and 150. They come towards the corner. They turn for home. A furlong and a half to go out in the middle of the track on the outside. Jake Sam on the 111 pounds and Ricky Walker on the inside. Janax Gold fighting back. It lies between these two. Jake Sam and Janax Gold. Jake Sam and Janax Gold. Jake Sam up by a head. Janax Gold weakened on the inside. Jake Sam for the monumental victory.
Lyndon Yard with a commentary. The great Jake Sam strong on the outside with top jockey Ricky Walcott, who is heading back to Canada soon for the first time in over 4 years, where he dominated at Northlands Park in Edmonton before his younger brother Rico Walcott took over, sweeping every jockey's title there since 2011. Jake Sam wins at 92 odds ahead of Janax Gold and Nikita, clocking 1 minute 52.40 seconds for 9 furlongs in the one-length victory. The 7-year-old gelding trained by Naz Issa for owner Mr. Brain.
The Antigua and Barbuda Triple Crown Series has now seen its opening event. A small field at Quesada Gardens Racetrack going in the Antigua Black Pineapple Stakes, including the outstanding demolition man on a 4-race winning streak. Here's commentator Ralph Francis as they headed for the home stretch.
Demolition man is holding there. A distant asset is coming up, but it's going to be demolition man. Demolition man now puts a length ahead. Demolition man begins to come up the incline. Demolition man is beginning to move. It's going to be demolition man. And both is now moving. The distant asset is running up, running to get into second place. But it's going to be demolition man this afternoon. And both of them, demolition man. Demolition man focuses Lambo, raising the second of distal asset, pump up, and that's all.
Written by Jeff Jacobs, Demolition Man dominates as the 1-2 top choice in the betting. Pulls clear of additional asset for the easy win by 5 lengths. Philly Classic winner Countless Liamsburg third for his 5th win in a row. Demolition Man clocks 139.33 for 7 furlongs for trainer Hazel Roy Barnes and owner Jerry Roberts. Demolition Man will now go for the Dr. Cuthlin Lake Super Sprint, the second leg of the Triple Crown, on the 3rd of May.
In Jamaica, 8 runners face the starter in the competitive Lady Keita Sprint over 6 furlongs. Here's how that one went at Caymanis Park. Brian Rickman on commentary.
They've left the half mile, arriving now at the 7/16th. It's a crucial appeal on that lead, a half a length ahead of Fortune 100. Opportune rated within third spot, trying to gain on them if they fold as they arrive at the 5/16th marker. Pochine now beginning to make ground on the outside of horses. They're into the lane, and the speedball crucial appeal is first into it. Fortune 100 on his outside. Opportune in behind them now asked to bubble to the boil. Toward the extreme outside, that's Pochine making some late progress, but watch crucial appeal. He has switched into another gear at the furlong pole and holds that lead over Opportune. Pochine trying his best to close. Perfect Neighbor will come late, but it's crucial appeal leaving the 16th pole in the Lady Geeta. Opportune closing too late. Crucial appeal wins the Lady Geeta trophy.
Paul Francis in the saddle shows off his riding skills for the surprise win aboard the front-running 6-1 bet, beating the 9-5 favorite Opportune and the 2013 Dabo winner Perfect Neighbor. Crucial appeal clocks 1 minute 12 seconds even and scores by a length and a half over 6 furlongs for trainer Patrick Lynch, owners Hammock Farms and breeder Edison Chai.
At TNT Santa Rosa Park, the fancy 3-year-old colt Clermont County captured the main event for 3-year-olds and over. Eddie Arnault picks them up down the backstretch with Clermont County stalking the leader.
As they race up the backstretch, and Slew Jerry is taking them along. Clermont County on the far side in second spot. On the inside in third is Coronio. Then on the far side in fourth, that's Canfield Casino. A length and a half back to Magic Russell. Lintak is starting to feel a pinch and has dropped away. And King Whistler continues to be the back marker. Out of the far turn they come. And here comes Clermont County now. Clermont County is travelling really well. On the inside is Slew Jarrow. Then 2.5 lengths back to Coronio. Clermont County now hits the front. Opens up by a length and a half. Slew Jarrow second. Coronio, the favourite, has work to do and looks as though he's in some problems with 200 metres to go. And Clermont County is sticking to his guns. He opens up again as Slew Jarrow tries to fight back on the inside. Coronio is a long way back in third, but Clermont County has him. Clermont County stretches right away to take the penultimate event by 2 lengths in the end.
It was a tough field, but Clermont County wins with authority on the jockey Previn Badry for trainer Shafi Khan, as an even money bet chased by Slew Jarrow at 5-2. The 3-5 favourite Coronio getting third, owned by the Aga Stables. Clermont County clocked 1 minute 11.20 seconds for 6 furlongs and won by 1 3/4 lengths.
We've been at the track covering top stories in the sport of kings. Check us out again next week.